Halloween is coming soon, and would it not be nice if you could experience Halloween in augmented reality? That's exactly what we'll do today. We're going to build a simple Halloween experience in augmented reality using Reality Composer. So to build our Halloween experience, we would need to import our own custom models of the different objects. So I've bought these from the online stores, and as you can see, I've already imported all of them here. And what you need to remember is that Apple only lets you use USDC 3D file formats in this framework. So any traditional formats like FBX or OBJ won't work, and you need to convert it into a USDC format before you can use it. And I'll do a video on that soon on how to exactly do that, and I'll link it up here. But for now, I've already done that, and I'm just going to drag these models onto the scene. So this is what it looks like, and now I'm going to breathe life into the scene one step at a time. So first thing what I want to do is when the scene starts, I want there to be nothing except the treasure object. So for that, I'm going to create a new behavior. And if you're not familiar with these, check out my other video that I've made, which I'll link up here. The new behavior, we're going to name it scene start. And I'm going to use scene start as the trigger. And the action would be hide objects. I want to hide everything except the treasure. So I'm going to choose every other object except the treasure. So now if I click play, you can see it's just the treasure there when the scene starts. That's great. So next thing we want to do is we want the treasure to invite us to tap on it when we get close to it. So we're going to do this through a jiggle action. So for that, I'm going to create a new action behavior. We're going to name it treasure invite. And the trigger would be proximity to camera, so when we're close to the treasure object. And the action would be emphasize. So this would emphasize the selected object, and we can choose the motion type to be jiggle. So it's a nice invitation for you to tap on it. So now if I click play, that's the jiggle in action. So that's great. And the next thing we want to do is when the user taps on the treasure, we want the three little monsters to appear in a nice way. So we're going to create a new behavior called treasure tap. And we're going to use tap as the trigger. Of course, the treasure object being the affected one. And the action would be a show action. So we want to show all these three monsters. So we're going to select these three monsters as the affected objects. So now if I click play and I click tap, you can see the monsters appear. But this looks boring. I want the monsters to appear in a more interesting way. So I'm going to choose motion type for the show action as move from the bottom. And I'm going to choose style as wild, just to make it a bit more interesting. So now if I click play again and tap, that looks much better. So next what I want to do is I want to create a behavior for each of these tiny monsters. So for the left and right ones, what I want to do is I want them to punch you on the face or pretend to punch you on the face so that you get scared away when you get close to it. So the punch animation is custom built with this USDC file. We bundle them together. And now let's add an animation. So I'm going to create a behavior for each of these monsters. So first, I'm going to create one for the left monster. And I'm going to use, again, proximity to camera as the trigger. And when it's close to the object, what I want it to do is play its custom animation, which is essentially a punch animation. And you can see that here. That's working fine. And next, I want to do the same for the right monster. So I'm just going to duplicate this behavior and I'm going to rename it to right monster. And I'm going to change the affected object from the left to the right. Great. And finally, I want to create a behavior for the center monster. Now for the center monster, I don't want it to punch. Instead, I want it to invite us to tap on it again through a jiggle. And when the user does tap on it, we want to show these large monsters in a nice way. That would be the final level. Let's create another behavior for the center monster. So I'm gonna create a behavior for the center monster. And again, it's gonna be proximity to camera. And now the action would be emphasize. And we want to emphasize by jiggling. So we're gonna choose motion type as jiggle. And again, I didn't choose a selected object. Now if I click play, that's the invitation to tap. So now that all looks good. And next thing, I want to create the tap action. So when I tap on it, these nice monsters would appear. So for that, I'm going to create a new behavior and call it center monster tap. And the trigger would be a tap on the center monster. So the affected object would be the center monster for the tap. And the action would be show. And what we want to show is these three large objects. So we're going to click choose, deselect the center monster, and choose these three large objects. So I'm going to choose this, that, and that. Now if I click play, you can see it appears. Again, to make this look a bit more interesting, we're going to choose the motion type as move from below. Now that looks much better. Now, what we want to also do is play the animations for each of these large objects after showing it. So we're gonna click another action and add it after the show action. And this would be the custom USD animation that comes for each of the objects. So we need to create one for each. So the first one, we're gonna choose the dragons. So this is gonna play the dragon's inbuilt animation. And we're gonna duplicate that. And this one, we're going to play the trees animations. And finally, we're gonna play one more. And for this one, we're gonna play the right dragon's animation. Now if I click play, what you notice it shows, but it's playing animations one at a time in sequence. That's because all these actions from show to animation 1, 2, and 3 happens serially. But what we want to do is for all the animations to play in parallel at the same time. For that, all you need to do is drag the animation and drop it onto the other one. So it's bundled, and we'll just repeat the same thing for the third one. Now that it's all bundled together, it will play together. This is how you play actions in parallel. So now if I click play, it shows, and the actions happen in parallel. That looks great. One final thing, we're just going to make the iterations really high so that it will keep playing for a long time. So great, so that's our models ready. And now let's test this out.